Yep. Salutations. Tonight's the night. All everyone that is just now being initiated into the KKK on this side for this region, this branch, will have to get a swastika tattooed in all red on your left ass cheek. It is part of what we're doing. Okay? We're gonna have KKK pride. And you, baby, let me talk to you. See, now we have a dilemma. Okay? See, the problem is that you're half and half. You got some of that shit in you, and you gotta pick a side, baby. You're gonna either, you gotta, okay, let me ask you like this. If we were playing duck, goose, would you be on your mother's team or your father's team? If we were to play duck, goose, what would you choose? Tell me, because this could determine everything. Good choice. See, I knew Beth Ann before she hooked up with Briz Rothstein and T-Top's homeboy, Carolina Ty 100. Before she went to the dark side. You know what I mean? Yeah. But anyway, let's get to the topic at hand. I'm glad to know you're with us. You're going to take care of the babies when we get there, okay? Just wait a second. Let me tell everybody else what they got to do. Look, we're going to get there. We're going to knock all the windows out of their houses. We're gonna make cocktail bombs and set the house on fire and put gasoline around there. We're gonna rape their wives. We're gonna do all that type of shit. Are you guys ready? Say yeah! Say yeah if you're ready to do that, boy. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Come on, get on your horses and we're gonna go do that. That's what we're gonna do to those innocent people right now. I know they're just working hard and having their little farms, whatever, but we're gonna fuck it. We're ruining it all. Ever since they got rid of slavery, I'm pissed off about that shit. And we're gonna fucking do that to their people. We're gonna fuck his wife. We're gonna take their kids, and you're gonna take care of the kids. Okay, you're gonna take care of the kids. Okay, you gotta take care of the kids. Okay, and we're gonna do that. We're gonna burn their houses down. We're gonna tear their churches up. We're gonna do all types of evil fucking shit to them. They just gotta shut up and take it, cause it's America. That's what we're gonna do. KKK, bitch. Yeah. Now, that's gonna make sense in a little bit to y'all. And the difference between the motherfucking KKK and the Black Panthers is, that's the shit that we were dealing with. And I'm pretty sure that the Black Panthers were created as a protection from all of that shit. As just, that's what we did because we got tired of dealing with that shit. What do you mean? And y'all, that'll make sense by the end of this blog. Like, this is not the same thing. Power to the people.
Yo, it's your boy, Carolina Top 100. Got Karina 75 with me. She woke up. She couldn't dang, I guess she couldn't sleep. She was in there going crazy, so I had to bring her out. So yeah, she in her night clothes, so I had to wrap up. I didn't want y'all checking out. You know what I mean? So, tonight what we doing? Chilla Jones recap. Chilla Jones versus TH3. How you feel about that? How you feel about TH3? Say amen, and you need to take me to church and get me Christian, Daddy. It's about that time for me to get baptized. That's right. So, we're going to do Chilla Jones, the TH3. Then we're going to hit you with that Chilla Jones versus QP. How you love that? Who give you 2-1? And today is bars and bullshit. So, this how we going to do this. With Chilla Jones and TH3. Let's go. I believe it was perfect day to die, man. That was a nice one. I like that one. As normal, I had to watch that battle a couple times to be able to say what I really thought, you know what I mean? I ended up gave that first round landslide, but it was fucking clear to me. I gave that first round to the Saga. The second round, like I said, I had to watch it a few times. And I also gave the first round from the Saga, I felt like was so crazy and was so strong, man. Like, I just do, man. If you haven't seen that battle, go check that battle. I feel like that first round was crazy. And again, I applaud him for what he does because I feel like, I personally feel like what he does is different. You know what I mean? And I feel like, I don't know, like he controlled the room. Don't cuss and stuff like that. You know, it takes, you know, talent and stuff to be able to do such a thing. And tell Danny, what's a bar guide to someone who literally writes God's bars? Let me find out the Saga one with Danny, man. I think that'll be crazy. I can't wait to see that. If that set that up, let's see that happen, man. And goddamn, QP said he want Danny and he want Danger. Say he want Danny and Danger Zone next, man. Y'all gonna let what's up, man? Hey yo, and that boy TY too, man. That boy TY Danny said he liked was crazy too, man. I actually did a vlog on him. I gotta find it so I can damn upload it, bitch. So what I'm saying is what do you say, mama? Crazy. She see that damn charm throwing. Yeah. But what I'm saying is I just feel like I don't know. I definitely gotta give him that, but I just feel like, you know, that second round I gave it to Chilla though. But I almost was, like I said, I feel like what he does is different. That's what I was saying. And I like what he does. God gave him a talent and he using it in that way. Just like God gave these other boys their talents too. You know, you don't just, I think it's because these boys are also the best rappers in the world, if you ask me. You know what I mean? So, as far as battle rappers go, you know, the way they put that stuff together, all of them can't make music, so they're not the best music makers. But as far as rapping, putting words together, I think they are. I gave my second round to fucking Chilla Jones. And I gave the third round to Chilla Jones. I seen those polls. And I'm not, I think they were, you know, they could have been debatable if you say that. I'm not disagreeing with that. I gave the last two rounds to Chilla. Shout out to the Saga still. You did your thing. I liked that battle. I think it was, you know, it was worth the wait to see or whatever. And I think, I gave it to Chilla. I seen the poll said 88 and 12 the last time I seen them. They were saying that Saga won that battle and everybody was saying that the polls could have been people were saying that the polls could have been must have been rigged or maybe all the Christians came out and voted and stuff like that, man. But I just feel like maybe people may have thought he won. I'm not gonna say that that's what happened, but I gave the battle to Chilla Jones. Who'd you give the battle to, mama? Okay. She gave it back to Chilla Jones, too. You sure? You sure? Yeah, she ain't gonna talk about it no more. So, the next battle. I told y'all I'd give y'all 2-1, man. Go check that battle of QP, Chilla Jones versus the Saga. Go see that if you haven't seen it. Then I also want to talk about Chilla Jones versus... Yeah, I gotta do that, man. I gotta say this, too. Because of Chilla. PSA. To all battle rappers, man. And I'm saying this because I can tell that Chilla Jones is listening to what fans say. You know, you can't... I'm not saying don't listen to what the fans say because you got to give them what they want and they're paying for you. That's the people that's coming to see you. And I know they probably told you not to scheme as much and stuff like that. But I just want to say, always continue to do what Chilla Jones does. You know what I'm saying? Like, because we like Chilla Jones. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what got you there. Like, you know what I mean? Regardless of what they say. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? And I'm not saying that you went way left field with trying to change things up. But just keep that in mind. And I also know you said that y'all don't care about what bloggers or whatever. Something like that. So, well, not necessarily bloggers. I guess probably people talking negative. I hope that's what you meant. Care what they say or whatever. I don't know. So QP, not QP and Chilla Jones. And I said that because I felt like in that Saga, some of those Saga rounds, I just felt like they were good, but I felt like some of them weren't as hard as, they weren't always the whole Chilla. You know what I mean? I don't know how to say what I'm saying. And you still got that battle. QP versus Chilla. Man, if you ain't seen that battle, go watch that battle. That battle was on, shout out to the URL, by the way. But QP and Chilla was at Black Ice Cartel, man. If you haven't seen that battle, go watch that battle. I'm telling you, that was a good battle, man. That was a fight. Chilla Jones be fucking working, man. Like, you can't deny that. You gotta give him that. So for that, I want to talk about that battle a little bit too, man. That boy said, so I'm gonna keep it, I'm gonna keep it G real with you, cuz that nigga damn QP crazy, man. I think I like the damn this QP off drugs, man. I do. I like the from Chilla Jones in his first round. I liked his Erica Mena bar. I like his against the rope synonyms joint. I like that's somebody in the crowd said that's a good reach though. That shit was crazy. Like his golden eye, about the blood coming down the screen, his golden eye bar. I like the Mark Cuban, you should own the Mavericks. I liked a lot. I like when he was like, squeezing on this bitch gonna make for a body like a waist trainer. Squeezing on this bitch gonna make for a better body like a waist trainer. That's crazy. I think his car scheme went crazy. I liked his Steve Harvey. He had a lot of punches. He did his thing in that first round. QP second round, I liked as well. He said, QP's first round, yes, I like that shit as well. His intro was crazy when he was freestyling. He came in, he was like talking about his pants and stuff, man. Y'all gotta see that. It really was funny, man. His new bar was funny. He told Chilla Jones he had the personality of a mannequin. I thought that was funny because, you know, they try to say like he don't have a lot of performance and stuff like that. I really like the sober QP. Shout out to that nigga, man. You know what I'm saying? For, you know, if he, you know, was really having drug issues and, you know, getting off, slowing down or whatever. Shout out for that. I'm gonna speak about it in a second too. So the second round, I don't know who. I'm not gonna call that battle. Still just yet. I've seen it twice though. I think it was a really debatable battle right now. That's what I think right now. If it seems like I'm giving off a murder vibe, it's cause I wanna steal. I like that shit from he was saying some crazy shit. I like now what's going on with Chilla Jones in AFM? Cause he said he wanted to call Angry Fan. He said I wanted to call Angry Fan Movement, but then I changed my mind. Cause that nigga ain't gonna keep it real with me. Like people keep saying like little stuff like that about him. Like what's up with this cat, man? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like what's up? Anyway, Chilla, I keep it real with you, goddamn it. I could definitely use the ratings and the views, like you said. But I'm Carolina 100. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna keep it real. I ain't gonna be chopping your interviews up all fucking shit. Like I don't know if that's what anybody do or whatever the case may be. So I don't pay a lot of attention to some of these guys. You know what I mean? I'm shocking your. I liked all that shit, though. He said, I'm shocking your dog's necks like an electric collar. Chilla did his thing. Now, on that second round from QP, QP went bananas in that second round. No debating. That nigga went fucking crazy. But he also rapped for a long time. You know what I'm saying? Like, he rapped, I think, for a long time, which I get why he did it. You know, he was making a statement. He snapped. That nigga said a lot of shit. He said, I'll unfriend you on Facebook and come poke you literally. He said, goddamn. Then I'll hold the spoon to your wound just to add insult to injury. Like, he said a lot of shit. I was fucking with that. I was fucking with that goddamn round. You know what I'm saying? The seasick, his seasick bar. He just said a lot of shit. He told Chilla, he said, nigga, you probably wake up scheming. Crazy. Like, see, you probably folding the blanket. This shit was funny. One thing that I wanted to say, I ain't go watch that battle if you ain't seen that battle. If you have not seen that battle, go check that battle. Black Ice Cartel, shout out to y'all. Motherfucking Chilla Jones versus QP. And if you ain't seen the prep, not prep, but Chilla Jones versus, we know what he did, the prep. If you ain't seen the fucking Chilla Jones versus TH3, the Saga, go check that out, URL. I ain't gonna call that battle like I said, but that brings us to damn near the end of the show today, or whatever you want to call it. We're gonna talk about the bars and bullshit. First of all, one thing I don't get that he said, he came back in his third round. We're going to talk about that. He was like, nigga, I only do coke. You act like it's crack. You know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah. What's up with QP, man? What's up with the other QP clean that I seen in his corner? I hope bruh doing good. Like, I would love to hear him back. And if he get out, I feel as if he probably sober up if he really have. I don't know what he do. I really don't care. That's not my fucking. And like I said, it's not going to change my life. But it'd be nice to have him around. You know what I'm saying? I like. Say it again. Say it again. I like what he does. Ain't that right? Say it again, mama. Say it again. You going to say it again? I like what QP does. You know what I mean? So, with that being said, you okay? I like what QP does. I would like to see him back. But what the other QP said in his third round was, he was like, wait a minute. He said, I only do coke and not crack. I get it in a second, too. He said, I only do coke and not crack. That's like people that, I don't care what a person do. I have people that I know that are friends of mine that will do snort powder, have done it for a long time. That's their prerogative. I don't do it. I don't choose to do it because my parents was on drugs and I don't want to be addicted to something like that. That's just my choice. You know what I'm saying? So, with that being said, like, I don't see a difference in coke and crack. Like, it's just people say that like it's such a big ass difference. And I sold it. Like, I know that, or whatever. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna say I sold. You know what I'm saying? But what I'm saying is, I don't understand how the hell, like, what's the, like, people. I've been in the trap with my homeboys. We'll be chilling. This mug might be hitting the bag and then talking shit to somebody that smoked crack. Like, it's baking soda. It's water and baking soda and heat is what turns cocaine into crack. The water, the heat, or the baking soda ain't what you addicted to. Y'all both addicted to the same drug. It's the cocaine. The cocaine in the crack is what. So I just don't see how people, like, that's, like, it's not a defense for saying I don't smoke crack. Like, I try to act like a person that do crack is worse than you because you just snort powder. I'm just saying, man. Like, that's, to me, because that's the main ingredient in crack, coke, nigga. You know what I mean? But anyway, still shout out, you know what I mean? Teach his own. But, what I was about to say, shit, don't turn down for me, goddamn, turn up. That's what you want to do. What I was about to say. Oh, man, that third round, man. I almost didn't even finish watching the rest of QP third round. I hate to say I still would have. I'm still going to because that's not fair to do. Talking about battle rap. But he said this nigga got a back page, man, and was talking about was going down. I hope that shit was just battle rap. Boy, I almost went to pull it up back page to try to see if he was up there. Talking about if it's for me and it's extra. What's extra? Like he said, nigga, what's extra, nigga? Extra what? You gonna do some extra shit for some extra money? Just extra fucked up. What the fuck, man? Y'all need, man. Better raise your goddamn battle fees. I'm just playing, man. I don't know, man. Whatever, man. Y'all niggas be tripping, man. That shit funny to me, though. Fun too? Hope not. Yeah, man. So, like I said, go check that battle, man. Yeah. But on to my bars and bullshit. So, This real, man, right here. The other day, you know, I was, you know, at home. I just went to Facebook just seeing what was going on. And, you know, everybody was going crazy on, everybody had been going crazy on what Beyonce said. You know what I mean? And, or not what she said or her wearing her outfit or whatever. So, a guy that I know that I'm friends with, shout out to my homeboy, Mike. He had made a post, and he was like, how come every time black people do something on TV for standing up for us black people, everyone got a problem with it? I'm sorry, we are tired of white police officers shooting us for no reason. That's all he said, and we all know that's been going on. I'm even going to provide a link up under this shit for something that I really want y'all to see. Like, I really want y'all to look at these links and tell me that I'm tripping. So that's all he said. And one of the links is over 102, or it's 300 and something people that's killed, but at least over 102 unarmed black people that were murdered in 2015 alone, shot by officers, man. Like, I'm scared to call the police, you know what I'm saying? Because I might get shot when they pull up. Like, it was this one girl that got shot by the police, and she was out there trying to break something up. Why did they even pull up shooting anyway at a fight? because it was in the area that you was in and you was nervous and you know, was, you know, it don't mean if you a police officer, you gotta break a fight up. You don't pull up shooting. That was just fucking, it's a lot of stuff. I'm gonna show y'all the links, man. We not tripping. Anyway, so he said that about how come every time somebody stand up for us, they get crucified. Nobody said nothing. The man was just venting. And one of his friends, which is a Caucasian man, interjected, "I'm not picking sides." First of all, that's how he started his statement. "I'm not picking sides." Okay, mama. He said, "I'm not picking sides, but more black people are killed by other black people than any other race. Hashtag facts." Now, I said, his Michael said, "Not true." And that's and that's not even the point of my post. Okay, so I interjected, cause like, how is that the first thing you say to him saying we frustrated for getting by getting harassed, killed, and treated wrong? Like your answer to that, your reply, your response to that as well is black on black crime, black people kill people. You know what I mean? Like you didn't, you know what I mean? Like that's not the answer to what he said. So I just said, cause I had just wrote a song the other day, or a verse, and I said, they shot Martin Luther, Merton Malcolm X, and beat Sandra Bland. I'm just saying, nigga. Hold on, y'all. Okay, mama. So I said, they shot Martin Luther, beat Malcolm X. I said, they shot Martin Luther, Merton Malcolm X, and beat Sandra Bland. I'm just saying, nigga. Was this really part of God's plan, nigga? Talking pledge allegiance and God we trust. Man, y'all really don't fuck with us. They kick us off and throw us under the bus. I wish Rosa Parks could really see this shit. Girl, you had you a seat. They got us under the bus. Put dope in our hoods, harass a nigga, then give him 35 years for trying to come up. So anyway, I had said some shit like that in my track the other day. So I sent him the link to that video and, you know, some shit like that just to let him know that's how I was feeling. I didn't feel like what he said was the answer to what, you know. So he reposted his shit. "I'm not picking sides, but more black people are killed by any other black people. More black people are killed by other black people than other race." So I told him, I said, "Maybe, but they get punished." I said, "But cops and Zimmermans, they get to kill us and get away with murder. Last year was a world record of African American kids being slayed by cops, and none of them posed a threat. They were unarmed. Did you see them drag Sandra Bland's lifeless body hogtied across the concrete after they beat her to death? And it super sounds like you're picking sides. But I get it, though." That's all I told him. You know what I mean? And I sent him a link to the video again. Am I lying? He said, "What do you get? I want to hear this." So everything I said, that's all he heard was like when I said, "I get it, though," right? You see what I'm saying? And that's the one thing he wanted to come to me about. So I said, because he was trying to see, think, I probably thought I was going to say he racist or something. So I said, "I think I would rather not. I said what I said, and I meant it. Fuck everyone that disagrees, and we are tired of the bullshit. People making excuses for these motherfuckers. Like, why was the first thing you could say was y'all kill each other? Sounds like an excuse for white people to murder us. You could have said, you're right, bro. This shit is wrong. That's what my girlfriend and the mother of my child, who was white, Caucasian, would have said. That's how she feels about it. That's what some other people that I know would have said. The first thing that they say is not, oh, well, it's black on black crime, so whatever. Nothing I typed was debatable, bro. How you put it? Hashtag facts. So he said, out of all of that, he said, really mature, man. Let me guess, I'm racist. Well, Michael Dot, his homeboy, which we're both friends with, a black dude, would tell you different. And he said, hashtag facts. I said, no, I don't think you're racist at all. I don't know you, and I don't need to ask Michael Bradley anything. You should ask him about me. It just bothers me when people defend that shit, and we already know that black on black crime is real. But ask yourself, why does it exist, and why is it so heavy? Now I wait. And trust me, you can't win this, bro. I can back up everything that I say, and there are facts and videos to support it. And I'm not attacking you personally. It's just this, it's just the shit that you said as a response to what he said was ignorant and bothersome. And I'm very mature. Don't be funny. The old immature me would make Michael show me where you are, and I would do an unannounced house visit. You feel me? LOL. But seriously, I'm just frustrated with America right now. And I said, Trevor, whatever his name is, watch this. He was just, I showed him Laquan get gunned down in the street with no weapon, just walking away from the police. They shot that boy 16 times, kept shooting and kept shooting as he fell. His name is Laquan. You can Google and search that. Laquan in Chicago, shot. He got shot by the police. Another police turned his, got his, gave his dash cam up. You see what I'm saying? They showed that they shoot him where you can see the fucking smoke coming out of his jacket. They treat him like a fucking deer. Just kept shooting and kept shooting. He dead as hell. They still, this man, the same officer still shooting. And the other ones, you know, all cops not bad. And the other dudes didn't do nothing, but they stood there and they watched him. They didn't stop him from doing that shit. They watched him do it. Nobody, they just watched him do it. Whenever they drug, that man drug Sandra Bland across the concrete, the other officer stood in the back of his car and just watched him do it. Which is crazy. So I said, he was just walking away from them with no weapon. They shot him 16 times. They treat us like fucking animals. Actually, animals are treated better and more protected than we are. Ask yourself, why did Michael Vick's dog get more justice than Mike Brown? And RIP Michael Brown, we won't forget. And then I showed him the raw video, Chicago Police dash video.
It's on YouTube, and it said raw video of Chicago Police dash cam a video of Laquan. So then, out of all that I just said, he only said, don't do that, man. That wouldn't end good for any of us. Out of all the shit I just said to him, and I did say what I would do if I was still ignorant because he called me ignorant. But out of all the shit I just said, that's the only thing he could respond to. So he said, don't do that, man. That wouldn't end good for either of us. I said, let me guess, you would shoot me. It figures. I'm done here. And you, like the rest, or a lot of y'all, them, because some are good, only hear what you want to hear. See, out of everything I said, that's your response? Shit, Craig. I was only giving an example of the immature Taiwan hooker since you indirectly called me that. I would never say some shit like that in FB if I had the desire to do so. Trust me. Mike will tell you, and so will Google. And that's real shit. I'm just being honest. Like, it will tell you. My very first charge was, I'll talk about it, and I'm not bragging. I'm just saying, like, my very first charge, I used to knock on people's doors and holler at them. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's public record, bro. It's not something I'm making up. Like, let me guess. You would shoot me? So anyway, no, I already did it. So I said, trust me, I wouldn't talk about it on Facebook if that's what I had some intentions to do. I said, if I did, though, I know exactly how it would end. The same way it always has. Me still free and a victim has a bad night. 3, you just said you are off today, which means you are usually at work. And Miss dot, 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 I ain't gonna call her name here, but I did there. Someone close to him that he live with can't stop my team, bro. Let him know, like, you on Facebook, you that type of person. You just said you off today. So I can, that lets me know that you usually work at this time. So if I wanted to get at you, I could. And I could make it where you would be, like, there's nothing you can do about it, bro. Not on that, but I'm just letting you know that. That's how I think. You just said you are off today, which means you usually at work. Miss dot, dot, dot can't stop my team, bro. 4, let's stop going back and forth before someone types something that crosses the line. Have a good day. He said, ha, 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 man, that's a good one. Yeah, evidently someone is in their emotions right now, and that line you're talking about got crossed. But I'm not over here upset, and when did guns get brought up in this? Jesus, jumping to conclusions. Guns got brought up into this whenever the very first statement, whenever my friend and your friend Michael said that they maybe we tired them shooting us. It takes a gun to shoot someone, and like, guns been in the conversation. So what the fuck you saying? So I was like, have a good day, I'm done. I'm about to have a little date with my daughter. Just next time a black man feels some type of way about America's bullshit, don't say that shit. Probably best if you say nothing. I've never walked in the shoes of a white man or woman, so I just shut up when they complain. It's not my place. And you're fucking right. I'm in my feelings, and so are the rest of us if you have not noticed. Hashtag black lives really do matter, bro. Rest in peace, Malcolm, Martin, Sandra, Laquan, Trayvon, and everyone else of those 102 people on that list of 2015 that were unarmed and got killed. So again, they slash y'all killed over 100 unarmed black people in 2015 alone.
Now that's hashtag facts. Look it up. Since you're off today, learn something about our culture and pain before you speak. I'm about to provide you with a few links. P.S. Happy Black History Month. And then he hit me with hashtag every life matters. I said, you're right. I just want the bullshit to stop, but none of us are God. Because I feel like some of them feel like they play the God role and they can take lives and it's not fucking fair. Like, I'm not God, you not God. Now me, if I take somebody's life or whatever, it's going to be because I'm protecting mine and protecting my family. Like, and I'll deal with that accordingly. I don't even think I'm going to get time for that. Like, me and my lawyer are going to talk to who we need to talk to and handle it how we need to. I'm going to go to court and deal with it. I'm not going to run from it. You bring some bullshit to me, I'm going to give it to you how you asking for it. Because how else I'm going to protect what I'm supposed to do? Let you harm me? You out your fucking mind. So, with that being said, then that's just what it is. But that was just bullshit to me, man. And then me and some guys at work had conversations about this, and you know, they felt the same way that I felt. Damn, I don't know. I just think it's and they were two of them were white, and they were saying that yes, America is racist, and the stuff that we're going through is wrong, like, and it is. And I had another guy try to, like, you know, he type of dude. He a good dude too. And he white, but that's my boy. He often, like, you know, he try to make excuses for people sometimes. And I know he don't mean to. It's just his nature. It's his character to feel like, to look for the best and be positive. But I told him, like, some people just got to realize that it's just point blank period. It's not your place to speak on some stuff that you've never been through. And I also provide a link. Make sure you click these links. I provide a link of, like, another lady. She's a teacher that was a white lady that was teaching, and she's saying damn near the same stuff that I'm saying. And my professors from school that were white, shout out to professors Amy Compton and a couple of my other professors. Who was it? My sociology teacher. Who was she? Miss fuck. I want to give her a shout out. But they talked about these type of things. You know what I'm saying? This ain't stuff that I'm making up. You know, they taught this to me in college and school. Like, and so it's evident, you know? And these weren't black professors that were telling me this stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, telling me about the glass ceiling effect and stuff like that. If you don't know what the glass ceiling effect is, in America, look that up as well. It's about African Americans and minorities reaching a point where they want to be as far as being successful within these companies and corporations. There's a certain level that you hit, and they call it the glass ceiling. Because you can see that next spot. You can see what it looked like to be a CEO. You see exactly what it takes to be that. But the chances are you're probably not going to be the CEO of that company due to your skin color. Just what it is. Not to say that it's not black CEOs and stuff like that. But the chances are you, the person that's probably watching this right now, are probably not going to outweigh the next person that this person knows, because he might play golf or whatever the case may be with this other dude's son just looking for the same type of job. You're going to get moved to that stack and he's going to get hired. It's just how it works. Like, but anyway, where was I at with that, man? Because that was just crazy. There's a lot going on, you know, so people just, if you don't understand from that situation, I don't think you should be. You should even speak on it. My whole thing to that man, that young man, was just don't even speak at all if you don't have nothing positive or nothing that's, you know, to say that even matters. Like, because people really feel some type of way about this, and it's hurtful. We hurt. We in pain. And you just can't say anything. You know what I'm saying? It's not okay. So I'm tripping. So with that being said, I don't know. I'm kind of going to leave it alone. I ain't going to keep going on that, because a lot of other stuff that I would say and I might say and I might probably should say, yeah, so I'm just going to leave that there, so I don't keep going with that, because there's a lot of stuff that I might say or that I want to say, and that it might not be the best for me to say, and we all know why. But shout out to Beyonce and to anybody else that will publicly take a stand and do little stuff like this, because she didn't even say anything. She just put on an outfit. Y'all say it's a freedom of speech, too, but y'all coming at her for even wearing an outfit. Like, it's just shit that's crazy. So, what I was saying earlier, basically, because a friend, you know, people was going in about that. Me and my boy had a conversation about that. And I also sent a shout out to my homie Delmar over at Supernova Battle League, had said in one of his comments, when have you ever seen a Black Panther? When have you ever seen a Black Panther rape a white? What, he's a name one white woman that's ever been raped by a group of Black Panthers. And that's, KKK was doing all types of foul shit to us. So, there's a big difference in what, you know what I'm saying? So, I don't know. I just think y'all need to pipe down, man. And it is what it is.
Or we supposed to just be quiet. You know what I mean? That's how it seems. Like, we not supposed to say nothing. Like, it's illegal, or we gonna get killed, or not gonna sell records, or whatever the case may be. You know what I'm saying? If we say that this shit is wrong, shit is fucking wrong, man. Okay, but anyway, I also wanted to say that my homie Delmar, man, I told you I got you. I just didn't know where I wanted to plug it at, and I'm still gonna actually review that battle. Omega, you got bars, homie. He actually the league owner over there, y'all, at Supernova, and he battle rap. So we might see if we can get Omega versus Smack or Omega versus goddamn ARP, since ARP got them ARP and it's a rare breed. Y'all know, you know, ARP got them little bars and shit. I heard you on the wax, bro. So maybe we can set that up. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Yeah, but you got bars though, bro. I fucks with that shit. You know, I'm fucking with the movement. I'm gonna watch it again and tell you exactly if it's what I think. I think it was a couple times in there. I wanted you to slow down a little bit, just a little bit. I think I gotta see it again and be right. But just keep doing what you're doing. You know what I mean? I fucks with you. Yes, and that RBE. Did y'all see that? Huh? Team Homie versus motherfucking Writer's Block? Huh? What? That's gonna be crazy to me. I'm excited for that goddamn J Murder and goddamn JC.
Writer's Block. Just,
you know what I'm saying?
It's gonna be stupid in the gun.
Thank you, me.
Yeah. I'm excited about that. I think that's gonna be a fucking fight. That's gonna be a fight. So hey, stay tuned. Y'all know I got y'all. Carolina Tie 100. Supernova Battle League, about to have that battle coming up. Prep, it's gonna be in March. DNA and Ty Law prep versus Luck Dollars, the whole nine. Like, it was a pretty dope card. Make sure y'all in the building for that and check. We definitely gotta go see that Team Homie versus Writer's Block over there, RBE. When is that? And what's going on with that? I need to check and see exactly what it is too. But I did see that card dropping. So good shit for the culture battle rap, man. And like, one more thing to the nigga that's been all in my comments and shit, so I know you watching. See, that's what I mean. We dealing with all type of shit like that, and you ain't got nothing else better to do but to try to fucking pick a fight or pick an issue with me. But like I said before, it is what it is, bro. Like, I'm all about that peace shit, but if you want to fight me or whatever the fuck you want to do, we can do that. I just wish you wouldn't be a pussy about it and keep doing whole shit, like making fake accounts and fucking shit like that. Like, I just don't respect it. But that's my point to you. So, like I said, man, we're going to holler at y'all, man. Carolina Top 100, make sure y'all stay tuned and all that, man. I got y'all. Subscribe, man. It's free, man. Just click the little button. Like, subscribe, comment, anything I need to get better on that you feel. Like, I always ask my people, something you want to see me do different, something you want to see me talk about, let me know. We're going to be doing some artist stuff, too, man. I might even get y'all some music with this. Hey, make sure you click these links. Make sure y'all watch these links I'm putting under here, because they're going to be about Laquan Davis. They're going to be about 103 people, 102 unarmed black people that got killed. And I want y'all to read through this and see how the people didn't even get charged for the crimes and just what it is. Like, it's fucked up. I'm going to put some other links, too, with this lady talking. She was a white lady. She was just telling, like, the administrators at her school, because they were trying to tell her certain things that she should tell her students. She's like, I can't tell these. She's teaching the predominantly black school students. Like, I can't tell them that. I can teach them math and science. I can't teach them about life because I don't live the life that they live. I never walked in those shoes. I never spent the night in the ghetto. Like, I don't know what they're going through. Like, that's real shit, though. And that's why, another thing, battle rap is a fucking outlet for us to be doing something different. Fuck all this bullshit fighting and shit in this battle rap shit, man. It's not fucking needed. It's not. Fuck. Just fucking rap. Handle your differences elsewhere, man. Like, it shouldn't even be nothing for half the stuff that we fucking fighting about, man. Carolina Tie 100, man. Like, subscribe, comment, and check them links. Peace. I love y'all, and I'll see y'all in a little bit. Boom. Duck that shot, though. I don't want to hit nobody. Boy, and how the fuck did I get? What's today? 12th or the 13th? Yeah, today 13th, ain't it? Y'all know what that means. Bear witness to dropping today. Show my nigga some love. Carolina time, stand up. Carolina, you buying everybody else goddamn music, buy his, man. When that CD drop, go get there. You can bump Future, you can bump all these other niggas. Listen to this nigga talk that shit. He representing for us, man. That's why I always tell y'all, it's about putting on for each other, man. Go get that Bear Witness 2 CD. I'm telling you, you gonna fuck. I believe I haven't heard it yet, but I know he won't plan. From the stuff that I have heard, the few tracks I have heard on there was fucking crazy. Check that shit by him and Grizz too. I ain't playing. It's about supporting each other, man. Ain't nobody gonna make it if niggas ain't T-Top can't be T-Top without fans and support. goddamn, nobody can't be the next person without help, man. We got to help each other. That's just what it is. Carolina Tide 100. Make sure y'all go get that album. Make sure y'all check these battles. And I'm really gone this time.
Hey, look, I'm just bullshitting, man. Y'all.